This girl was walking on the street. Was seen by two police academy cadets. Two brothers decided to bet on a match. If she turned her head, then they would go up and ask for the phone number. What a coincidence. This girl really turned her head, and the girl didn't know. This turn saved her life. Two brothers used men's ways when deciding who to ask for the phone number. Then suddenly happened. Two brothers saw it all, quickly ran after her. This guy with glasses is called Hyeol, and the guy who's a bit thinner is Ki-jun. Depending on the running power of these two boys, they couldn't keep up with a four-wheeler. At an intersection where the car was lost trace, the two quickly ran to the police station to report the case. They even met Sunbunim in school here. Sunbunim said that now they had to mobilize all their forces, because the grandson of a big business owner went missing, so there was no one left to help the two of them for the time being. Ki-jun looked at the watch and immediately remembered what he used to learn in school. When the victim was female, 80% of the perpetrators would kill her within 7 hours. Two people couldn't see death couldn't save. First, they went back to the crime scene to find more clues. They noticed a cake that had fallen on the road. After asking about the bakery for many years here, they finally found a clue at the store down the block. The enthusiastic hostess even told they where Juhi worked, but this place, it was a forbidden area. How we do it? It's okay to go in to find information, but if the school finds out, they will be expelled. But here is the only clue. Then they decided to rock, paper, scissors. Hyeol lost twice in a row, could only accept entry. Ki-jun was on guard. Hyeol scouted for information. Hyeol doesn't even have a girlfriend. How did he see the scene? When he saw a pretty girl, his eyes lighted up, and Ki-jun was standing guard outside, saw the scene. Ki-jun was very excited right now, but he wouldn't be able to leave his best friend alone, unless it's one more sausage. Ki-jun was sipping noodles, suddenly discovered the police coming, and that's where the girl was. To hide, Hyeol was looking for information. Ki-jun could only run to provoke two policemen to get their attention. Two uncles. Come on, catch me. After running a big lap until Hyeol got out of there, he was dragged away by Ki-jun. Two people cut their tails off the police, went the address that was written on a piece of paper. But the person who opened the door was a well-dressed blonde guy, in hand still hiding a knife. After knowing that two brothers came to find the other girl, immediately closed the door and turned the left lock, then jumped out of the window and ran away. He could escape the first, but he couldn't hide past the fifth. Hyeol went to the garage and caught the blonde. He used a combo martial arts, subdued him. Through his cell phone, two brothers knew. Turns out he was out of pocket, so he sold Juhi to human trafficking. Two brothers forced him to give out the contact details and address of the traffickers. What are these human traffickers up to? Another place, in a pitch black room. A man is slowly walking towards Juhi. He injected Juhi with a tube of medicine. The two of them, based on the blonde boy's address, went to a restaurant. Ki-jun took out the blonde boy's phone to make a call. As expected, the phone of someone nearby rang. Ki-jun hastily turned off the phone. Unexpectedly later, the two were immediately exposed and joined hands with the opponent. Very quickly the group was defeated. They pinned the leader to the ground, then used red-hot iron, forcing them to tell where Juhi was being held. After the two of them found out where Juhi was being held, Ki-jun continued to be in charge of the watch, while Hyeol was in charge of going inside to save Juhi. Hyeol saw a stamp drop on the hallway. He carefully considered the situation around. Suddenly, later was a constant cry for help. Turns out it wasn't just Juhi who was locked up here. Ki-jun heard movement, then asked the thug what happened in the end here. After hearing the answer, he was very angry. Inject. Get eggs. Couldn't manage this guy anymore. Needed to go to the rescue immediately. Two brothers working together to break the door. Inside was a girl who was only 10 years old. Moreover, she still had a high fever. The whole blanket was full of blood. The two brothers knew that they needed to get her to the hospital quickly, otherwise her life would be in danger. The two of them hurriedly took the girl out, but outside there was a group of thugs. They were already here waiting for two brothers. Urgent situation. Hyeol told Ki-jun to run first, but this road turned out to be a dead end. The brother in the back also rushed up. Stunned two brothers. These two wanted to save the girl who was kidnapped by traffickers, was knocked unconscious hanging in a room. Ki-jun used his strong body. A flip, he has successfully escaped. Then the two of them decided to take the opportunity to escape. No other way, the two brothers could only carefully tiptoe to pass. When they went halfway, All the thugs woke up, two people running on the street crazy. The thugs in the back with sticks were chasing them non-stop. When the group of thugs was about to catch them, they successfully ran to the police station, immediately pressed charges, but that they couldn't provide evidence, and their language was a bit too extreme. Finally, the police on duty could only hold them temporarily, until the next day the school professor came. Only then did the police agree to release the person. They took the professor to the attic of the captive girls, but after one night they were detained, the place where the girls were imprisoned before. Soon there was no one left. They begged the professor to help them, but the professor told them, this big case required the help of the police. Wanted to get help from the police, the fastest it took a month, then through a phone call, knew that the license plate of the group was a false number plate, for the safety of the students. The professor warned them, wasn't investigated this case anymore, otherwise, they would be expelled from school. They returned to school with a bothered heart. The girls were taken away, clear clues in front of eyes. While they couldn't do anything, but they didn't wait to die. They, through the help of their classmates, had contact with a female officer before. The female officer agreed to help them track down the whereabouts of the back car, but it took a while. Two brothers had experience from last time, realizing that their physical strength weren't enough. They started to practice. After a few days of hard work, they have gained muscle mass. Finally, one day they waited for the female officer's phone call. She told them, this car entered an illegal surgical hospital. Could see this group of human trafficking, definitely cooperated with this illegal hospital, more pitiful than, because of the poor situation. After the surgery, these girls didn't treat their wounds properly. Many girls were infected with infectious diseases. This time, they would operate to remove organs, to earn some money, and hospital doctor, just helped the girls made profiles. Then gave it to infertile families, so they could get rich. Today they were lucky to meet a couple who came here for surgery, so all the girls were sent to the hospital for selection. Two brothers armed weapon, then carried a stun gun and taper. This time they needed to save those girls, in the garage. One hand holding a taper, a stun gun in one hand, facing a group of dozens of thugs. Two people weren't scared at all. In addition, he hit very strong. Finally, they successfully dealt with the group of thugs. They took the elevator to the hospital. The elevator doors just opened. They met the leader of the human trafficking group. He relied on alone to deal with them, but this time they totally doing their best, that they took the opportunity to strike down the leader, finally cuffed him. Then they stormed into the operating room, first, gave the doctor a slap, then saved all the people here. When they called the police, they thought of the worst case happen. In the meeting room, the police and the school were arguing fiercely. Some people have supportive, some people say that punishment must be severe. And now, the professor finally spoke up. I used to have righteous thoughts like them. It's right to do so. Finally, they were kept. After watching this movie, I feel very excited. If you feel distrustful in the life around you, good and bad are all according to their desires. The police and the school were arguing fiercely. Some people have supportive. Some people say that punishment must be severe. And now, the professor finally spoke up. I used to have righteous thoughts like them. It's right to do so. Finally, they were kept. After watching this movie, I feel very excited. If you feel distrustful in the life around you, good and bad are all according to their desires. So this movie will light up the spirit of justice in your heart. Okay, the movie ends here. See you next time.